Hello everyone, Killecow Divine here playing Football Manager 2017. We are playing with Grasshoppers in the Swiss League. And we are at the top of the table with 27 matches played. 56 points, 5 points ahead of Basel and 6 points ahead of Young Boys. And things have been going very well for us. We can also see here that there is some odd thing. But there are a second table, and in that one is for the second half of the season, and we are second place in that one, but it should not count. It should be this league, this table, that is the real one. 9 matches left to go in the season, 1 match against every team in the league. We start off with St. Gallen, and I'm actually a bit interested to see past meetings here. We won the first one, then we tied, and then we lost 2 times, 1 in the Swiss Cup. So we absolutely would like to get at least a point against St. Gallen this time around, but it would feel really good to get a win as well. And we also see that we play against Basel away late in the season, and at home against Young Boys. Those 2 matches will be super important, I'm going to assume at least. The first 18 matches, Munas de Boer was our star player, the absolutely best we had. He was absolutely amazing. He won us a lot of points on his own. Second half, the last 9 matches, he's been awful. You can see his form is 6.58, and I think he has scored 1 goal in those 9 matches. We are not happy with him. We're gonna let Cherko Gubari start maybe a few matches. Maybe Nikola Sukachev will start a few matches as well. Nikola Sukachev is very tired at the moment because, he might have been on international duty actually, Sesiger and Sukachev. That might be why they are a bit tired. Doesn't really matter. We will rest Sukachev this match. Then we will decide if Gubari will be allowed to continue to play, or if Munas de Boer needs to come on. But I feel we might as well leave Munas de Boer out of the team for now. Instead, it's been Rich Munsey filling the position of the top goal scorer. He has been magnificent in this the spring part of the season. Actually, Munas de Boer scored against St. Gallen as well. Well, then he has scored 2 goals in these nine matches. But Andersen have also been scoring a few. Rich Munsey hat-trick against Sion. 2 goals against Lausanne. So you can see he's been doing very well. 2 goals here against Lausanne as well. 9 matches left to go, and we are in a great position to win the Swiss Super League. And looking at the results, we are very good at the moment, but on the pitch, I am not so sure. Actually, I'm not so sure we deserved any of these wins. Let's look at the goal against St. Gallen. It was actually St. Gallen dominating this game. They had 12 shots, but only 1 on target. We had 1 shot before this chance came up, and it missed the target. But the first time we get it on target, it is a goal, and it's the only goal in the match. We can see St. Gallen dominated this match. After the match against St. Gallen, we took on Thun. We won 3-1, but you can see it is a late turnaround. And it was the debut match of our young midfielder, Vincenz Baruché. Very good talent. And we just need to look at it. There he comes, and there he scores. 16 years old, first match, and he won this match for us with that goal, because after the goal, we started to create chances. 2-1, one more goal coming as well, as Munsey finds Dabur in the middle. and we managed to beat Toon 3-1. Very nice result to get. Actually, this time it was Dabur who got the only goal in the match. Lavanchi, Basic, Baruchet, Munoz, and then Dabur open net. At least he is able to score when he got the open net. You can see it was we were a little bit better than them, but it was still a close game. Could have gone either way. We then played against Lucerne, and they scored the first goal. Let's watch. One time, two times, and then the third time hits the mark. But we managed to get it back to a draw. Lavanchi, Manzi, and Manzi have been scoring a few goals like that. Lavanchi passing in, and then he stands outside the first post and finds the net. Then we played against Lugano. It was surprisingly close. Manzi should get the first goal of the match here. We can see Caio is playing his first match again after his, I think it was 5 months, a long injury either way. Then they took it back. I think this was a nice goal, even if it was the wrong team. A decent shot. We gave him a lot of space. But then, one of the last things that happened in the match, a corner kick. Antonov with the corner, Sesiger with the header, and we win against Lugano. And now we have 4 matches left to go. And of course, after these good results, we are now in the lead with 9 points. But Basel still have 1 more match to play. So it could possibly be 6 points. But we can see that the top 2 is finalized. This would be a super good result to win the Swiss Super League first season. I didn't expect that, honestly. I thought we would battle for 4th place. But the young team have been absolutely amazing. Big problem, we have a lot of depth. We need to make changes to make sure we can turn the economics around. We are the champions. Grasshoppers win Super League. Wow, that was a big surprise. You can see Basel dominating the last seasons, but this time it was something else, and we can see that it was the match against Basel that finished it all. Let's look at the schedule for a little bit. We had a match against Lausanne. We won 2-0. Rich Manzi and Caio scored the goals. Let's look at them. Wow, that is a great ball by Andersen. Sukachev finds Manzi in the middle, and we score the first goal of the match. And then second match for Caio, and he scores again. Very nice to see that. Actually, that was probably his first goal after his comeback. I think it was an assist in the previous match. Here against Basel, it was we stole that ball, and Manzi finds the net. Andersen with the pass. And then Caio started to play like that. Great finish. Long shots is one of the strengths of Caio. And other than long shots, he's also great with the free kicks. And he ended the match with the third goal of the match. His second. Wow, that was... We beat Basel away 3-0 to secure the win of the league. We are also in the lead in this table, the second half of the season table. But now when we got the news in the inbox that we are the champion next season, we have 2 matches left to play. This is absolutely amazing. I'm not really sure what to say. I was expecting a struggle. We can see that Sesiger wants an improved deal. I want to remove that, but we can give him a pay raise. And actually, we can't afford what he is asking for. So I guess we need to walk away. And the season is over. We get some money. Very nice to see that. The end of the season, on the other hand. 1-1 against Young Boys. Not sure how the match was really. Yeah, we were much stronger. We should have won that. Nikola Sukachev scored the goal for us. And it is Valera who found Sukachev, and Sukachev scores. Do not need to see the Young Boys goal. Against Vaduz, we gambled. We tried some new things in the team. For example, putting in 15-year-old Dominic Thomas. And we also played with Vincent Sparucci. So, well, we were much better again, but they scored the only goal of the match. So the season is over. We can see that Basel was stronger in the second half of the season. But this, the full table, we are 4 points ahead of Basel. Actually 13 points ahead of Young Boys. Surprisingly good season for us. And we can see that we have the two people who scored a lot of goals. Munas Dabur in the first half of the season. Rich Mansi in the second half of the season. When it comes to assist, Lucas Andersen was very good for us. 11 of them. And Lucas Andersen was the best player this season. And Munas Dabur, he dropped down a lot. He was so amazing in the first half of the season and so awful in the second half. Rules of Swiss Super League. Top team qualifies for European Champions Cup group stage. We will play in the Champions League next season. We are already in the group stage, so well done us, I guess. We skipped past Europa League and went straight into Champions League. Transfers. We have signed, actually, let's do this first. We're gonna keep Joel Moll. He's a Swiss keeper. He will go down quite a lot in wages. He's already on a new contract. I think we paid him 5.25k euro each week, but now we almost put that down in half. So very nice. And as you saw here, we're also gonna sign a new goalkeeper, Nestor from Celta Vigo. He should be about on the same level as Joel Moll and Vasic, but he will have a higher potential ability. So that's nice. We get him for free. He's a free transfer during the summer, so we do not need to pay anything. And we can see his estimated cost was quite high, so I feel like it's a good signing for us. We will see who will be the first keeper next season. We have the team of the year. Munas Dabur, Andersen, Antonov are in the team from our side, and also Joel Moll, the goalkeeper. Best goalkeeper, Joel Moll. Best midfielder, Lucas Andersen. Best attackers, best strikers, Munas Dabur and Rich Mansi. And we also have Antonov as the third best defender of the season. And our end of season awards. Lucas Andersen gets the most votes, and Rich Mansi is in second place, Munas Dabur in third. Goal of the season, Lucas Andersen against Lugano. Let's have a look at it. Andersen, that is a nice goal. Very nice finish. Signing of the season, Xavi Munoz. That was a very good signing, I felt as well, because he's been one of the best players for us this season. A young player of the season, Lucas Andersen, 22 years old. We have a team full of young talent. And this is what the board thinks about us end of the season. I felt like we did good. We won the league, surprisingly. And, well, we lifted up a lot of young talents. We did everything we should do. Squad harmony is also high. I think we should be super happy. I think this was, might be one of the best seasons I have ever played. At least the best first season of a club. Yeah, a bit surprised. But sometimes it goes your way. That will be the end of this season, the end of this episode. We have a lot to do next season. Prepare ourselves for the Champions League. But until then, I am Killer Cow Divine. Thank you all for watching.